This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Piggy, Infected, an original novel by Terrance Crawford and Dan Widowson, read by Fred Berman. Chapter 1. There had once been an island called Lucella, far past Doveport and somewhere south of the North Sea. Its outer edges were sprinkled with long beaches and stretches of picturesque mountains that led to a salting of dense forests. The breeze off the North Sea meant there was often a chill in the air. It wouldn't have been out of place to see the residents of the island bundled up in jackets or scarves on their way to the metro station. But that was then. That was before the infection. If there were stars in the sky above the city of Lucella this evening, you could not see them. A dense mist hung above the island, blanketing the entire city in a thick layer of fog. The wind tore through the trees, making a distinctive howling sound and causing Ben to pull his hoodie tighter around his shoulders. He considered calling it a night then and there. These last couple of weeks, he'd had his fill of jump scares. To anyone else, the house in front of him was just like any other on the block. Three levels, picket fence, a closely manicured lawn. To Ben, this was his best friend's house, and the last place Ollie had been seen. Ben wondered if it was too late to turn back and go home. It wasn't as if there was much waiting for him there, either. He had lost track of his own family a while back. He hoped that they had made it off the island before it had locked down. There were dozens of safe spaces across the island, and Ben was confident that the grown-ups could take care of themselves. But Ollie, Ben was all Ollie had. Ben felt a rush of chills go down his spine, completely unrelated to the strange weather they were having. It seemed like just a few weeks ago, everything had been so normal, and now? Well, now this. Ben shook his head, clearing the spookier of his thoughts and steeling himself for the task at hand. The aging brown wood of the picket fence creaked eerily as Ben pushed his friend's gate open, walking purposefully toward the front door. He had made this journey 1,000 times before. Why did it seem so sinister tonight? Ben traipsed up the front steps, reaching out to knock gingerly on the mahogany front door, which loomed much larger than he seemed to remember. His knuckles rapped on the wood, the sound seeming to echo across the empty street. The hairs on the back of Ben's neck stood on end. He had gotten used to making as little noise as he could. "Ollie?" Ben cried out in a half whisper, not wanting to attract any unwanted infected attention, and not sure himself if he was expecting an answer. "It's Ben." Again, this was silly. He had known Ollie since they were both in diapers. "No one's seen you. With everything that's going on, I'm worried about you." No response. Ben jiggled the handle of the door in vain, but it was firmly locked. He couldn't blame Ollie's family. The more he heard about the infected citizens of Lucella, the more Ben wanted to lock his doors and hide it too. And if that was what they wanted to do, they were more than welcome to, as soon as Ben made sure that Ollie was safe. He cupped his hands and called his friend's name. Again, no response. Ben sighed in resignation. This marked the beginning and end of his ideas. Surely, if Ben could get inside, he would find some trace of Ollie, some clue as to where his friend had disappeared to. Of course, the front door wasn't the only way to get inside the house. Ollie's house had always had the biggest windows in the neighborhood, and Ben was certain he had seen a good-sized rock on his way over here. Normally, it was important to respect other people's property, but things hadn't been normal in Lucella for weeks. Skipping down the steps of the front porch, Ben made his way across Ollie's front lawn and down the street he had come from, back toward his own house. In another neighbor's yard, a collection of rocks led up to their front porch. Ben would only need to borrow one for this job. Pocketing a smooth stone, Ben made his way back up the street to Ollie's house. Ducking behind a parked car, Ben took in his surroundings, making sure that no one was around. The infected citizens of Lucella were one thing, but nosy neighbors were a whole other can of worms. The street was illuminated by only the dull, buzzing shine from the overhead street lamps. Chills shot over his whole body again, nerves causing Ben's fingers to tremble. If Ben's parents had been around, they would have certainly disapproved of his plan. No, this wasn't just nerves. Ben couldn't shake the feeling that he was being watched. That was when he saw it. Now that he had seen it, Ben was actually baffled that he had been on the lookout. It had snuck up on him, but it wasn't exactly inconspicuous. Twice his height and bearing down on him quickly was one of the infected. Ben didn't know how to explain it, but the people of Lucella had started acting strangely recently. For what seemed like no reason at all, large swaths of the population had recently become violently ill, and the ones who recovered, they were different. People were saying it was a sickness, an infection. But others weren't so sure. Whatever it was turning the regular people of Lucella into monsters. The infected weren't worried about manners or hygiene. They only obeyed their base instincts to feed and to attack. And now, Ben was face to face with one. The creature made a distinctive grunting sound as it raised its arms, brandishing a metal wrench. The infected was at least 8 feet tall, dressed in an ill-fitting tattered red shirt. Its skin was pale and swollen, like it had been left in an inflatable above-ground pool overnight, and it smelled like a breakfast restaurant's sink that hadn't been cleaned in weeks. Ben's every instinct screamed out at him to run, but his legs wouldn't listen, and he found himself paralyzed by fear. The infected pig creature roared again, its eyes bloodshot and glowing red, its smell almost overwhelming this close. Ben threw his hands up reflexively to defend himself, the rock skittering across the pavement. The noise distracted the pig, and it turned its head to follow the new sound. This was Ben's chance. He couldn't overpower the infected pig, but if he got away, maybe his search for his friend would not be over before it began. Ben tried to control his breath as he forced his legs to obey him this time. He scrambled to his feet, allowing himself a small whoop of victory. He couldn't believe he had managed to overcome his panic. Just one more thing he would have to tell his family and Ollie once he found them. If he could beat one of the infected by himself, then he could thwack. Ben's reverie was interrupted by a single blow from the creature's wrench. Ben fell to the ground, his head spinning. Ben didn't know how much time had passed when his eyes fluttered open. He groaned in response to the throbbing on the crest of his skull. Naps were not high on the list of things you should have after a head injury. The constant hum and broken-down fluorescence of the streetlights had been replaced by the warm glow of a table lamp, and the biting chill of the North Sea's wind on the street had been replaced by the warmth of a home? Ben sat up, his head aching, almost as if to remind him that he had been assaulted by a wrench-wielding pig. As if he needed reminding. Ben stood up carefully, regaining his footing. He had never been in such close contact with one of the infected before. He hoped he would never have to be that close to one again. What in the world was that thing? It looked so familiar, and yet Ben had never seen anything like it before. But he had seen this furniture. This room. Ben had been in this house before. He groaned as he gingerly touched his fingers to the knot growing on his head. Ben had planned to use one of the stones from down the street to smash in a window, then crawl in and search the house from there. Aside from the massive splitting headache, getting pignapped had turned out to be a much simpler way to get inside Ollie's house. But why had the pig creature attacked him? And more importantly, how did the pig creature get inside? Ben had an idea, but he pushed it to the back of his mind. He didn't want to consider that right now. His head throbbed again in the spot where his skull had been introduced to the infected pig's wrench. It certainly wasn't pleasant, but Ben figured he would be okay. He opened the bedroom door, peering down the hallway for any sign of the creature. In a lounge chair in the middle of the living room, the pig creature slept soundly. At least, that's what it looked like to Ben. Its massive head hung over its chest as it took labored breaths. Ben had no idea how long he had been out, or even what time of day it was. Ben looked past the slumbering pig creature to the front door he had been on the other side of not so long ago. He could make a break for it right now. He might not have anything to show for it, but he would make it out with his life and a story to tell. Across the hall, even closer than the front door, was Ollie's room. Ben weighed his options. He could run for the exit, head home, and try again some other time when he wasn't nursing a probable concussion. Then again, wasn't this why he had come here to begin with? Hadn't his goal been to find something in Ollie's house that would help him track down his friend? What if Ollie had left a note, a calendar date, anything? If there was even a chance that Ollie had left a clue, Ben couldn't risk missing out on something like that. Before all this, Ben's parents had always told him he was hard-headed, but even he didn't think his head could take any more whacks. It was now or never. Putting as little weight as he could on each foot, Ben tiptoed across the hallway, every step causing the floor of his friend's house to creak a little too loudly for Ben's liking. It was torturous. One wrong move could wake the infected pig creature, and Ben didn't know much, but he knew that he wasn't up for another bout with the infected so quickly. After what seemed like an eternity of sneaking across the hall, Ben reached his friend's room and quietly turned the doorknob. Ben sighed in relief as the latch clicked and the door gave way. He never thought that he would be thankful that his friends didn't lock their bedroom doors. Ben closed the door behind him, making sure the click of the latch was silent as his relief turned to sadness, now facing the fact that his friend might actually be gone. Or worse, maybe he was one of them. Ollie's room was exactly as Ben remembered it. The bed, dresser, and chairs arranged in the same way that they always had been. If Ben didn't know any better, he would have thought that it was just another day after school. A faint, sharp crackling sound pierced the silence of the room. Ben's heart dropped to his stomach, and he thought for a second that the infected had woken from its sleep and found him. No, it was just one of Ollie's walkie-talkies. For a few months, it had been all he talked about, though like many...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.